Hey guys, what's up? Dan here with a new video. 100 divines of profit in 5 hours with this amazing Legion Dunes farming strategy that we're gonna take a look at today. This is quite a popular farming strategy, however this league most players are magic finding. If you don't want a magic find and if you wanna farm a mage blood in 5-6 hours, well, you can run some Dunes and you're gonna be making 20-25, maybe even 30 divines profit per hour if you're gonna optimize the things a bit. I was running these legions on my Arakali Spango Cultist build, which although has really good clear speed, it's still a minion build. It's not tornado shot, we're not able to use headhunter, so I was only able to clear around 80-90% of the legion, and even though running these maps with an unoptimized filter and picking up a lot more loot than I should have, spending a bit more time per map than I should have, I was still able to farm 100 divines of profit in 5 hours, which is absolutely insane. If you wanna try them out this league, you're probably gonna enjoy yourself a lot and you're also gonna be able to farm a lot of currency, boys. Let's take a quick look at the Atlas. This is the Atlas skill tree that I use to farm 50 maps with Legion Dunes. We have a Synthesis, Shaper Elder and Conqueror maps. Increased effect of modifiers in our non-unique maps. We are specced into Heist, we have some of these block nodes here. We're specced into the Wrath of the Cosmos Searing Exarch Altars, we are specced into Legions. And we are also specced into the 7th gate, since Legion is not on the map device this league. This node right here gives you access to all the crafting options that are available in the game. So this keystone is really nice. But in order for 7th gate to work, you need to have 6 gateways allocated. We have 2 here, we have 4 here, and we have 6 here, right? If we take these 6, we're gonna take the 7th gate, and we're gonna be able to get an extra Legion per map. Now, let's take a look at how I was configuring these maps. We have Dunes maps that we're gonna buy in bulk and we're gonna scour them, chisel them to 20% quality and we're gonna use an Orb of Alchemy. I was trying to roll these maps to around 75% of quantity, although some of them had a bit more like 100% quantity, 110% quantity from time to time, but my plan was to take them to 75% quantity since I have some increased effect of modifiers and I was also running 3 sacrifice fragments. We're only gonna be using a polished Legion Scarab and that's it, no other scarab for this farming strategy, and we're gonna add this compass for an additional Legion encounter. Something really important that I need to mention before we take a look at the loot. You're probably gonna need to run these nodes if you're not playing a build that has a similar clear speed to Tornado Shot or a build that has really good clear speed and is also able to use a headhunter. Without these, I wasn't able to clear the legions efficiently, but with these, as you guys can see, we have so much increased duration here and they also take increased damage while in stasis, so I was able to clear around 80-90% of each legion that I was seeing in my maps, even though I am running a minion build. Let's take a quick look at the loot. This is the loot that I got from 50 maps, Legion Dunes. We have 7 Divines, 9 Exalts, a lot of currencies from the Alders, a lot of currencies from the Incubators like the Stack Decks. We have some Scarabs, Fossils, we have Sacrifice Fragments, we have a lot of Incubators, we have 1 Delirium Orb, a Memory for around 2 Divines, 1.5 Divines for this Blueprint right here, and 11 Fortunate Cards. Let's take a quick look at the second tab as well. We have a lot of emblems, guys, and in total we managed to assemble 19 sets. Each set right now, so 5 of these right here, go for 2 divines, guys, right? So 38 divines just from the emblems, which is absolutely insane. We have deception contracts at around 12-15 chaos in bulk right now. Blueprints 40 C each. We have Shaper Elder, Conqueror and Synthesis maps. We have our invitations here. We also managed to drop another invitation, the Twisted, which is around 1 divine. We have a lot of Dunes maps, we have a lot of Glacier maps adjacent, really nice for running legions, and we also have a few gems. Now let's take a quick look at the numbers. Okay boys, and here are the numbers. 1 divine is around 159 chaos. We have around 33 divines from currencies, we have 67 divines from scarabs, essences, fossils, the emblems, a lot of things here. 15 divines from maps and our big drops, lucky drops at around 4 divines. Now I need to mention something before I show you the profit per hour and the investment. I'm gonna be really busy this week with work. I'm not gonna have enough time to make a video on Saturday, on Sunday when I'm gonna release this video on YouTube. So on Saturday you're gonna come to the pinned comment of this video. You're gonna click on the spreadsheet link and you're gonna see the actual prices for Saturday. Now let's take a quick look at our investment. It's at around the 50k as invested per map, and we are getting 320k for those 50k as invested, which is really nice, right? So we invest 50 and we make 320k profit per map, which is absolutely insane. Our profit per hour is at around 20-21 divines profit per hour on the Arakali Spango Cultist. If you're gonna optimize your loot filter a little bit and if you're gonna run a faster build, you should be able to hit around 25 divines profit per hour. For those of you that are slightly slower than me, you're gonna be able to run these maps in around 7 minutes and you're gonna make 17-18 divines profit per hour. Please keep in mind, for most farming strategies, you're usually able to run them slower and make less profit per hour, but with Legends, it's not really like that. You can run these maps slower, or maybe you have a character that has slower movement speed, or maybe you wanna play a bit more casual and pick up the loot a little bit slower, but your character should still have good, really good clear speed. This is a farming setup in which you need really good clear speed if you wanna hit these numbers. If your build is not able to clear 80%, 90% of the Legion, in my opinion, you should probably not run this setup. Right, so around 20 divines profit per hour in my case, and I'm pretty happy with the results. Now, the numbers are a bit inflated because you're gonna be using these incubators here, but you're not gonna use most of them. So let's try to remove some of them. We're gonna be using the Ornate, Diviner and Skittering, and you're also gonna be able to sell them without any issues. So we're still at around 20 divines profit per hour, 17 here for those that have slightly slower movement speed, and for the ones that are a little bit faster, profit per hour went down from 25 to 24 divines profit per hour. But this is not a farming strategy that I could run for hundreds and hundreds of maps, because as much fun as it is, it's an intense farming strategy. There's a lot of clicking, you have to be fast, you have to be efficient while you're running these maps. It's a lot of fun to run 50, maybe 100 maps, but this is not something that I would consider running more than 50-100 maps per league. Something really important that you should probably do before running this Legion setup is come to this website, pov.remaps, is gonna be listed in the pinned comment of this video. And this is my recommendation for your rejects to be able to complete these Legions. You don't want to run cannot regen maps, and you also don't want to give the Legions defensive mods, because if you're going to give them monster life, if you're going to give them maximum life as extra energy shield, my build is running poison damage, so if I'm going to give them chaos resistance, maybe you have a build with physical damage, so physical damage reduction is not good there. I am also using a lot of curses, so I can't run these mods if I want to clear these Legions efficiently. The plan for these maps was to make them as deadly as I can, so there were a lot of really dangerous mods, but there weren't a lot of defensive mods that I allowed on these maps because I wanted to clear the Legions efficiently. Now, let's say that you're a new player, you don't know how to use this website, select these mods right here, and then you're gonna get a rejects. You're gonna copy the rejects, you're gonna paste it inside the game, and then you're gonna start rolling your map, right? So we're gonna chisel the map 4 times, quality 20%. In case it's unidentified, you're gonna scour it before that. And then you're gonna start rolling your map, and you want to keep it highlighted, guys, right? So for example, this map has 60% less effect of curses. I am not gonna do a lot of damage if I'm gonna run this mode. So I'm gonna scour and I'm gonna alk again. This one, 75% minus max resistances, 60% chance to suppress and hinder on hit with spells, right? So this is a map that I would run because with the sacrifice of fragments, I'm gonna be able to take it to 100% quantity. It looks tedious if you're gonna try to roll your maps one at a time. However, if you're gonna roll 50 maps, it's not gonna look like this because you're gonna scour all of them, you're gonna alk all of them. You're gonna take the good ones, put them to the side, scour the rest, alk again, put the good ones to the side. And this is how I've done this rolling session. It took me 7 minutes. 7 minutes to chisel, alk, scour, and roll these maps. So really important, use this rejects, and you want to look out for quantity, minimum 75%. And this is how I managed to farm 100 divines of profit in 50 maps. It was a lot of fun. For those of you that don't have amazing clear speed, use the nodes that grant the Legions increased duration. You're gonna be able to clear most of them. You should still be able to hit 17-18 divines of profit per hour. If you don't have good clear speed, try another farming strategy. You have so many farming strategies on this channel with really good results, even better results than this Allegiant setup right here. And for those of you that are running extremely fast builds, well, you probably already know how to run Allegiant and you're probably making a bit more than I managed to in this 50 maps test. It was a lot of fun and I'm gonna leave you with two map showcases. The map that's currently running in the background is one in which I overlapped the legions. So I was clicking on the legion, I was clicking on the second legion as I was fighting the monsters from the first legion. I was overlapping them, but I'm also gonna give you a map showcase. If you wanna run a legion, pick up the loot, run a legion, pick up the loot, run it like that, a little bit more comfortable, although probably a little bit less profit per hour. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments below. I hope this video helped you out a little bit. Don't forget to drop a like and a sub, it helps out the channel a lot. If you want to, you can join the Casual Dan Discord. Maybe you have some more questions about this farming strategy or about the build. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye guys.